before the most recent crisis, the children of Central African Republic suffered some of the worst conditions in the world. The latest crisis to rock the country has affected 4.6 million people, either directly or indirectly, with mass looting, violence, and insecurity that has rendered even the most basic services defunct. Health centers and hospitals have been looted across the country, and doctors and nurses have fled the most affected areas.
J'ai eu trop peur parce qu'il y avait des retentissements des fusils, des balles perdues. Même on avait reçu une balle perdue sur le toit d'une salle ici. Heureusement que ça n'a pas touché un enfant ni une mère. Et que nous vivons dans une peur parce qu'on ne sait pas la sécurité encore. Non, ce qui fait que même pour venir au travail, on a peur.
Water systems that functioned before the crisis have fallen into disrepair due to lack of maintenance, pillaging, and unavailability of fuel for generators and pumps. Schools are closed throughout the Central African Republic. Only a handful of private schools have begun to open their doors in the last few weeks. Children are extremely vulnerable to violence resulting from lawlessness, displacement, and recruitment of children into armed groups. Since March, UNICEF has distributed 141 basic health kits, essential drugs and equipment to hospitals, health centers and partners in the health districts of Bangui and 5 of the most affected prefectures. For nutrition, UNICEF has ensured continued therapeutic feeding to cover 4,000 severely malnourished children. UNICEF also supported the first in a series of emergency measles vaccination campaigns with a 99% coverage rate in Bangui.
Isso a Sara Sila se gaginando so a que problem ti meni mala. Problem ti mala ni a Sara si teret me ngini a ki son. E muna lo ko be a Sara si lo yeti te ina pe. I force lo ba lo yeti te ni la pe. Ni la sa si a godata go provoke malat ni so a gala si son.
UNICEF is working with partners and the Ministry of Education to engage children in recreational and psychosocial activities, using schools as an entry point while building the confidence of communities to re-engage in education. UNICEF is working to release children who are with armed groups, provide immediate care and support their reunification with families and rebuild their futures. UNICEF has supported the state water company Sodeca with water treatment chemicals to ensure the continued provision of clean water in the capital and is partnering with NGOs to ensure the repair of water points that are no longer functioning. Humanitarian access has significantly improved over the last few weeks, enabling UNICEF and partners to launch a significant humanitarian response. However, UNICEF and partners are seeking urgent funding to ensure the provision of emergency services for the children and women who have been most affected in this forgotten crisis.